It's nighttime in the big city. Outside, the dogs are barking. A woman walks barefoot, her high heels in her handbag. It's Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan.
It's time for Theme Time Radio Hour, and tonight we're going to be talking about the most beautiful things on Earth, the fine-smelling, colorful, bee-tempting world of flowers, the bougainvillea, the passion flower, the butterfly chlorodendron, the angel's trumpets, the firecracker plant. We're going to be talking about Rosa rugosa, the angel face, all that jazz, double delight, the Gemini and the Julia child. We're going to be talking about the knockout shrub, the new dawn, the Mr. Lincoln. And that's only the roses. We're also going to hit on the Silver King, the German status, the globe thistle and the Joe Pye weed, the violet, the daisy, the lovely chrysanthemum, the yarrow and the tansy. We'll be hitting on the bachelor's button, the cock's comb and the lion's ear, the leaven of mist and the victorious sorghum. I just made that one up. We're going to be talking about flowers on Theme Time Radio Hour. Thomas Beecher said, "Flowers are the sweetest things God ever made and forgot to put a soul into. Anything that beautiful is going to inspire a lot of songs, and the next hour is going to be chock full of them. We're going to start things off with the morning glory of a song by the king of Western swing, the man who pretty much invented it, Bob Wills and his Texas Playboys, doing his theme song, The New San Antonio Rose, a bridal potpourri.
San Antonio. it passed by the Alamo and rode my road to San Antonio.
Bob Wills and the New San Antonio Rose. It was called the New San Antonio Rose because he recorded a fiddle instrumental called San Antonio Rose 8 years earlier. Perhaps the most famous rose garden is the one in the West Wing area of the White House. It was established in 1913 by Ellen Louise Wilson, wife of Woodrow Woody Wilson. Let's move out of the rose garden for a second and move over to the boxwood border of the grass and go grazing with the Friends of Distinction. This song was written by South African trumpet player Hugh Masekela, but it became a big hit when it was recorded by the Friends of Distinction. Grazing in the grass. I can dig it, you can dig it, we can all dig it. Let's dig it together, shall we? That was Friends of Distinction, Grazing in the Grass. Speaking of grass, George Jones once had to drive down the freeway on his riding lawnmower. His wife, Tammy Wynette, was sick of his constant drinking. She emptied the house of liquor, she took away his car keys, and made him a virtual prisoner in an attempt to wean him off the booze. One afternoon, alone in the house, George wanted a drink. The house was quite a distance from Nashville, too far to walk. So George hopped on the only vehicle he still had the keys to. You could see George heading down the side of the highway, going towards the liquor store on his Rodham lawnmower. Here's George Jones with A Good Year for the Roses.
I can hardly bear the sight of lipstick on the cigarettes there in the ashtray. Lying cold the way you left them, but at least your lips caressed them while you packed. And and a lip print on a half-filled cup of coffee that you poured and didn't drink. But at least you thought you wanted it. That's so much more than I can say for me. It's been a good year for the roses. Many blooms still linger there. The lawn could stand another mowing. Funny, I don't even care. It's been a good year for the roses. After 3 full years of marriage, it's the first time that you haven't made the bed. I guess the reason we're not talking, there's so little left to say. We haven't said. While a million thoughts go racing through my mind, I find I haven't spoke a word. And from the bedroom, the familiar sound of our one baby's crying goes unheard. But why? Funny, I don't even care. And when you turn to walk away, as the door behind you closes, the only thing I know to say, it's been a good year for the roses.
I can hardly bear the sight of lipstick on the cigarettes there in the ashtray. A good year for the roses. George Jones on Theme Time Radio Hour. Robert Frost had something to say about roses, and this is his poem called A Rose is a Rose. It goes like this. A rose is a rose, and was always a rose. But the theory now goes that the apple is a rose. And the pear is, and so's the plum, I suppose. The deer only knows what will next prove a rose. You, of course, are a rose, but we're always a rose. Robert Frost, frosty poet. Of course, Gertrude Stein took it one step further with her immortal poem, A Rose is a Rose, is a Rose. And then, of course, there's Roses are red, violets are blue. Some poems rhyme, this one doesn't. Paul Clayton also has a song about roses. Paul has a lot of songs. He traveled all around the country collecting them. During the 50s, he made a collecting tour with Liam Clancy, and together they found a whole bunch of blues, ballads, and gospel music. I don't know if this one was among them, but it sure is a great song, all about young Bonaparte, concerning the bonny bunch of roses. Paul Clayton.
By the dangers of the ocean, one morning in the month of June, the feathered warbling songsters, their charming notes so sweet did tune. Their eye espied a female, a seeming in grief and woe, conversing with young Bonaparte, concerning the bonny bunch of roses, oh. Then up spoke bold Napoleon, as he took his mother by the hand. Now, mother, pray have patience, until I'm able to command. I will raise a terrible army, and through tremendous dangers go. In spite of all the universe, I will gain the bonny bunch of roses. Oh. Now when you saw Great Bonaparte, you fell upon your bending knee. You begged your father's life of him, he granted it right manfully. 'Twas then he took an army, and all the frozen realm did go. He said, I'll conquer Moscow, then go to my bonny bunch of roses, oh. He took 300,000 men, and likewise kings to join his throng. He was so well provided, enough to sweep the world along. And when he came near Moscow, nearly overpowered by driven snow, all Moscow was a-blazing, and he lost his bonny bunch of roses, oh. Now, son, there speaks so venturesome, old England is the heart of old. England, Ireland, and Scotland, their unity has ne'er been broke. Now, son, look on your father, in St. Helens his body lies low, and you'll soon follow after, so beware of the bonny bunch of roses, oh. Oh, mother, adieu forever now, I'm on my dying bed. If I had lived, I should have been clever, now I droop my youthful head. And while our bones do molder, and the weeping willows o'er us grow, brave deeds of bold Napoleon will sting the bonny bunch of roses.
That was Paul Clayton and Bonny Bunch of Roses on Theme Time Radio Hour. Roses have been named after a lot of famous people, as a Cinderella rose, a Cary Grant rose, a General MacArthur rose. Roses have been named after Judy Garland, Lady Diana, Snow White, Sir Lancelot, and Chevy Chase. However, the Himalayan blue poppy has nobody named after it. Christopher Marlowe wrote in The Passionate Shepherd to His Love, "Come live with me and be my love, and we will all the pleasures prove that valleys, groves, hills, and fields, woods, or steepy mountain yields. And we will sit upon the rocks, seeing the shepherd feed their flocks, by shallow rivers to whose falls melodious birds sing madrigals. And I will make thee beds of roses, and 1,000 fragrant posies, a cap of flowers and a kirtle, embroidered all with leaves of myrtle." That's how Christopher Marlowe said it. Kim Shattuck and her band The Muffs have another way of putting it. was the Muffs, Raising Cane, and playing on A Bed of Roses on Theme Time Radio Hour, where we're talking about flowers. Maybe a little bit too much about roses. They're not the only flowers, and we know that. There's all sorts of flowers, and they're all beautiful. As a matter of fact, here are some official state flowers. For our friends in Alabama, you got the camellia. In Alaska, we have the forget-me-not. In Arkansas, it's the apple blossom. California, it's the California poppy. In Delaware, it's the peach blossom. For our friends in Georgia, it's the Cherokee rose. In Minnesota, it's the pink and white lady slipper. Mississippi has the magnolia. In Nebraska, it's the goldenrod. New Mexico, of course, has the yucca flower. In New Hampshire, it's the purple lilac. In Tennessee, it's the iris. Aloha to our friends in Hawaii, where the official flower is the paualoa. And of course in Wyoming, it's the Indian paintbrush.
Surround your home with natural beauty, add charm to your private world.
Landscape for personalized luxury.
If I was born with the name Luscious Venable Millinder, I would be happy with that. But he changed it to Lucky and fronted one of the swinginest bands that ever played. If nothing else, he was the man who introduced singer and guitarist Sister Rosetta Tharpe to the American audience. But he made plenty of records on his own, and none of them swung better than this tribute to the fruit-bearing vine of the grape, which only makes sense because Lucky Millinder retired from music and spent his later years as a liquor salesman. Here's Lucky Millinder and his grapevine. I wonder if he used this as his theme song.
Just plant a grapevine on my grave and let the juice drip through. Milk and honey are mighty fine, but I like the juice from the good grapevine. So plant a grapevine on my grave and let the juice drip through.
Drip juice, drip. Drip juice, drip.
A trip through. If I get sick and put in bed, hang a grapevine over my head, open my mouth and hold it wide and let the juice drip inside.
Drip, juice, drip. Drip, juice, drip. Drip, juice, drip. Drip, juice, drip.
So open my mouth and hold it wide and let the juice drip inside. They make me over again. Plant some grape seeds under my chin. Let the grapes grow over my lips so they can drip, 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 drip.
Drip juice, drip. Drip juice, drip. Drip juice, drip. Drip juice, drip.
So I open my mouth and hold it wide and let the juice drip inside.
I'm starting to see pink elephants on that one. Milk and honey are mighty fine, but I like the juice from the good grapevine. Lucky Millinder, the grapevine. Here's a song about some choices. Tulip or turnip, rosebud or rhubarb, filet or plain beef stew. This one's by Duke Ellington and his orchestra.
Bye. but a rhubarb fillet, plain beef stew. Tell me, tell me, tell me, dream face, what am I to you? Diamond, a doorknob, sapphire, a sawdust, champagne, just homebrew. Tell me, tell me, tell me, dream face, what am I to you? Do I get the ruby prize, or will I be the hero? Am I heading for blue skies, or is my ceiling zero? Tulip or turnip, moonbeam or mud pie, bankroll or IOU. Tell me, tell me, tell me, dream face, what am I to you?
Duke Ellington and his orchestra, featuring the great Ray Nance on vocals. Ray was also a fine trumpet player and one of the most famous jazz violinists. The tulip was introduced to Europe in the middle of the 16th century and soon became very popular in the Netherlands. It rapidly became a coveted luxury item and status symbol. A single bulb could cost as much as 1,000 Dutch florins. By 1635, they were worth 100 times as much. A sale of 40 bulbs was made for 100,000 florins. Just to give you an idea of how much that was, a ton of butter only cost 100 florins, and 8 fats wine, 240 florins. In February of 1637, tulip traders could no longer get these inflated prices. They began to sell, and the bubble burst. It was worse than Black Friday, the stock market crash of 1929. To this day, economists use the phrase tulip mania to refer to any large economic bubble. They might have been better off with turnips. Tiny Tim was a character who played around Greenwich Village in the 50s and 60s, and a lot of people just think that he was a joke. But I'll tell you, no one knew more about old music than Tiny Tim did. He studied it and he loved it. He knew all the songs that only existed as sheet music. When he passed away, we lost a national treasure. Here's Tiny Tim, and the only song that made it to the top of the charts and kept him in the public eye. Here's Tiptoe Through the Tulips on Theme Time Radio Hour.
Tiptoe through the window. With me, oh, tiptoe from the garden, by the garden of the willow tree, and tiptoe through the tulips with me. Meeting in flower we'll stay, we'll keep
That was Tiptoe Through the Tulips by Tiny Tim, a song that sold over 200,000 copies in 1968. When Tiny Tim got married on the Johnny Carson show, it was one of the biggest events in television history, and deservedly so. His daughter from that marriage was named Tulip. Beauty itself is a fading flower. Another flower that faded is the wildwood flower. We're going to hear the wildwood flower by the most influential group in country music history, the Carter Family. They switched the emphasis from hillbilly instrumentals to vocals. Alvin P. Carter, his wife Sarah, and their sister-in-law Maybell sang pure, simple harmony. A.P. collected hundreds of British Appalachian folk songs and recorded them, enhancing the pure beauty of these facts-of-life tunes. It is one of the best, still fresh as a daisy. Wildwood Flower. Originally a written song from 1860 called I'll Twine Mid the Ringlets. These songs were passed around from person to person over a long period. By the time the tune got to the Carter family, many people claimed to have written it, and like a game of telephone, some of the words stopped making sense altogether. I will twine and will mingle my waving black hair with the roses so red and the lilies so fair, the myrtle so green of an emerald hue, the pale amanita and violets of blue. These lyrics are difficult to interpret. There is no flower named amanita. Some hear it as the pale and the leader. Somehow, amidst the confusion, the song still makes sense. I got another song that A.P. Carter composed or found. Another song about roses. This one's called When the Roses Bloom Again, and it's by a young singer from Nashville, Tennessee, named Laura Cantrell. British disc jockey John Peel called her album, Not the Trembling Kind, my favorite record from the last 10 years, and possibly my life. Here's the title track from her second album, When the Roses Bloom Again, Laura Cantrell.
Roses are in bloom. A soldier and his sweetheart, brave and true. And their hearts are filled with sorrow, for their thoughts are of tomorrow. As she pins a rose upon his coat of blue. Do not ask me, love, to linger when you know not what to say. For duty calls your sweetheart's name again. And your heart need not be signed that I'll be among the dying. I'll be with you when the roses bloom again. When the roses bloom again, and the sun is on the river, the mockingbird will sing its sweet refrain. And in the days of auld lang syne, I'll be with you, sweetheart mine. Oh, I'll be with you when the roses bloom again. With the rattle of the batter came a whisper, soft and low. Our soldier, he is fallen in the fray. I am dying, and I know I've gotta go. But I wanna tell you before I pass away. There's a far and distant river where the roses are in bloom, and a sweetheart who is waiting there for me. And it's there I pray you'll take me. I'll be faithful, don't forsake me. I'll be with you when the roses bloom again. When bloom again, and the sun is on the river, the mockingbird will sing its sweet refrain. And in the days of auld lang syne, I'll be with you, sweetheart mine. Oh, I'll be with you when the roses bloom again.
Taking time to stop and smell the roses. Laura Cantrell, When the Roses Bloom Again. Laura became a mother this year, giving birth to young Isabella May. Congratulations, Laura. I was golfing with Ricky J, the magician, and he told me something interesting.
There are many stage acts that made use of flowers, but more interesting than that was a very early Dutch woman. Off the top of my head, I can't remember if she was 17th century or 6th century, named Eva Fliegen, who was supposed to have lived entirely off the scent of flowers. Ate nor drank food or water, but lived entirely off the scent of flowers. It was presented as a religious oddity rather than someone you actually paid to see perform. But she did, I think, rather enjoy if people left donations.
Well, there's no shortage of road songs. And here's one I first heard through the grapevine. It's from a young Welshman named Geraint Watkins. He played piano and accordion with Dave Edmonds and Shakin' Stevens. But more recently, he's been in Nick Lowe's band and has recorded and toured with Van Morrison. Here's a beautiful song that he wrote, "Old Dear Rose," Geraint Watkins.
"Old Dear Rose, Old Dear Rose, Old Dear Rose for my darling. Only a rose, only a rose, only a rose for my darling. She was my pride and joy. She was my everything. She was my pride and joy. She was my everything. Only a rose, only a rose, only a rose for my darling. Only a rose, only a rose, only a rose for my darling."
By any other name, would still smell as sweet. Gonzalo Perez from Austin, Texas sent us an email. He asks, "Can I plant pansies in the fall?" Well, Gonzalo, traditionally, pansies were the first spring annual I sent out each year. I eagerly await their appearance at my local garden center. No matter how much I picked and deadheaded, by June, they were leggy and limp from the heat. And I pull them to make room for something else. But now, late summer varieties are available. They may go dormant in cold winters, but they revive in the spring. Happy planting from Theme Time Radio Hour. I wasn't going to play any more Rose songs, but how could I not play this one? It went to number 3 in 1967, and it's called I Threw Away the Rose. We've talked a lot about Merrill, so I'm just going to play the record.
Of wine and roses, and I drank a lot back then for one concern. Success for me lay just around the corner. I thought my social friends would help me make the turn, but now I'm paying for the days of wine and roses, a victim of the drunken life I chose. Now all my social friends look down their nose, 'cause I kept the wine and threw away the rose. I stood by and watched the bottle take control of me. The turn I made was not the one I'd planned. And I watched my social standing slip away from me. While I watched the bottle slowly take command, and now I'm paying for the days of wine and roses, a victim of the drunken life I chose. Now all my soul down their noses, 'cause I kept the wine and threw away the rose. 'Cause I kept the wine and threw away the rose.
That was Merle Haggard. I Threw Away the Rose, with his story of unrequited love. This is Theme Time Radio Hour, and we're discussing flowers. Buddha said, if we could see the miracle of a single flower clearly, our whole life would change. Georgia O'Keeffe, who knew a little bit about flowers, said, when you take a flower in your hand and really look at it, it's your world for a moment. On the other hand, according to Mencken, a cynic is a man who, when he smells flowers, looks around for a coffin. Mencken was definitely not someone who ever let the green grass fool him. Another person like that is one of the roughest and sweatiest soul singers of the 60s, Wilson Pickett. Don't let the green grass fool you.
Girl, try to remember when we didn't have no shoes. Together, just me and you. It took a long time to get what we got today. Now you wanna give it all up for another guy, baby. I'm telling you, don't let green grass fool ya. Don't let it change your mind.
to feel my life all over. Cause baby, you got the love that I really need. Cause if you leave me this way, baby, you know what? I may not live to see a brand new day.
That was Wilson Pickett. Don't Let the Green Grass Fool Ya. The centerpiece of the 1970 album, Wilson Pickett in Philadelphia. He got a bunch of hits on Atlantic Records, but after the hits began drying up, he gave a pair of young producers, Kenny Gamble and Leon Huff, a chance to update his sound. We're just about out of time here, and I gotta get home and water my azaleas, but we got time for one song first. Roses are the most popular flower to give, so let's hear one more song about them. Why not make it Alan Toussaint? Alan just did a new album with Elvis Costello, and they wrote a bunch of new songs together. Here's one of them called The Sharpest Thorn. Hard as a pistol, keen as a blade. The sharpest thorn upon parade. Elvis Costello, Alan Toussaint.
I wore my finest suit of clothes, the sharpest thorn defending the rose. Hard as a pistol, keen as a blade, the sharpest thorn upon parade. And it's the same most every year, cause of the beauty parted and near. We raise our glasses and we cheer. Should old acquaintance disappear, just as we wipe away a tear, Archangel Michael will lead the way. Archangel Gabriel is ready to play. Although we know we must repent, strongest cage that guards the prize, the longest lash that covers your eyes, a sight no eyes are meant to know. Then on the third day he arose. Archangel Michael will lead the way. Archangel Gabriel is ready to play. Heaven even been invented, so good and evil were ever to fight. It lasts much longer than any one night. It may last longer than a life, and turn a mistress into a wife. And so confetti fills the air, my head
my pockets were bare. I didn't recognize their warning. Then I wasn't born the sharpest thorn. I wasn't born the sharpest thorn.
Saint and Elvis Costello, The Sharpest Thorn, from the album The River in Reverse, on Theme Time Radio Hour. Well, it's been an hour, so I gotta make like a tree and leave. But don't worry, I'll be back next week with more dreams, schemes, and themes on Theme Time Radio Hour, your perennial favorite.
It's nighttime in the big city. A pet poodle scratches at a window. The last piece of pie is gone. It's Theme Time Radio Hour with your host, Bob Dylan.
Welcome to Theme Time Radio Hour. Look up in the sky, there's a moon hanging there. Some people think it's made of green cheese, and a man once walked on it. It inspires romance and creates werewolves. And for the next hour, is going to be the subject of Theme Time Radio Hour. This is your man in the moon welcoming you to 60 minutes of lunar melodies. In the background, Charlie Parker playing Ornithology, based on the chord structure of How High the Moon, which tells you that the moon is far away and love is far away too. Tonight, we'll be talking about the moon. Thank you. that one should knock some heads together. Next up, we've got a song based on the chord structure of ornithology. Bless Paul and Mary Ford, How High the Moon. The Moon. Bless Paul and Mary Ford. Les invented multi-track recording. He put a microphone above the sink so Mary Ford could sing while she was washing dishes. He had his arm broken and he had it set at an angle where he could keep playing guitar. How about that? He opened a restaurant on the moon. They had great food, people said, but no atmosphere.
Welcome, Commando Cody. I am Retic, ruler of the moon.
Why do you want to invade the Earth?
Because the atmosphere on the moon has become so thin and dry, it is impossible for us to raise food, except in pressurized greenhouses. And none of us can move outside without helmets. So we are planning a mass migration to your world.
You will find that conquering the Earth isn't so simple.
Next up, Chuck Berry, Havana Moon, showing the influence of Calypso records. Me all alone with a jug of rum. Me waiting for the boat to come. Me open the jug of rum. It's a long wait for the boat to come.
Havana moon, Havana moon. Me all alone with a jug of rum. Me stand and wait for boat to come. It's long the night, it's quiet the dark. The boat she late since 12 o'clock. Me watch the tide easing in, is low the moon, but high the wind. Havana moon, Havana moon. Me all alone, me open the rum, is long the wait for boat to come. American girl, come back to me. We'll sail away across the sea. We'll dock in New York, the buildings high. We find a home up in the sky. Havana moon, Havana moon. Me still alone, me sip on the rum. Me wonder when the boat she come. To bring me love, ow! Sweet little thing. She rock and roll, she dance and sing. She hold me tight, she touch me lips. Me eyes they close, me heart she flip. Havana moon, Havana moon.
come American girl. She tell a lie. She say till then she mean goodbye. Havana moon, Havana moon. Me lay down alone, was good to run. Me fall asleep, the boat she come. The girl she look till come the dawn. She weep and cry, return for home. The whistle blow, me open me eyes. Was bright the sun, was blue the skies. Me grab me shoes, me jump and run. Me see the boat head for horizon. Havana moon is gone to rum. The boat she sail, me love she gone. Havana moon.
Chuck Berry, Havana Moon. Chuck didn't turn a deaf ear to anything. Calypso influences in songs like this, the hillbilly influence in songs like Maybelline, and straight blues in songs like Jay McShann's Confessing the Blues. He ended up on Chess Records because he met Muddy Waters, who encouraged him to go to Leonard Chess, who owned the label. From East L.A., Los Lobos means the wolves. This is the title song from their album Kiko. Out playing make believe. Nobody can see. Then he waits. And then he fakes. And then he bends. Then he shakes. He plays and plays, still playing, till he goes off to sleep. Kiko and the Lavender Moon. Los Lobos.
Thank you.
Los Lobos started out as a Mexican wedding band, but eventually became part of the punk rock scene in L.A., opening for the Blasters and X. They had a song out a while back called Will the Wolf Survive, which Waylon Jennings had a hit with. Kiko and the Lavender Moon on Theme Time Radio Hour, where we're all about the moon. That's one small song for men, one giant melody for mankind. One of the great stride piano players, Fats Waller, by the light of the silvery moon. I want to spoon to my honey, our croon love's tune. We'll be cuddling soon by the light of the silvery moon. Keep a shining in June. Silvery Moon. Fats Waller, one of the best writers and piano players in jazz. Songs like Ain't Misbehavin', Honeysuckle Rose, and Jitterbug Waltz are just a tip of the iceberg. It was on a moonlit night. Your love, it said goodbye. Blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Bill Monroe.
Blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine on the one that's gone and proved and true. Blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine on the one that's gone and left me blue. It was on a moonlight night, the stars shining bright, and they whispered from on high, your love has said goodbye. Keep on shining. Shine on the one that's gone and say goodbye. keep on shining. Shine on the one that's gone and left me blue. It is on a moonlight night, the stars shining bright. They whispered from high, your love said goodbye. Blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Shine on the one that's gone and said goodbye.
A man from Kentucky sure is lucky. Blue moon of Kentucky, keep on shining. Bill Monroe, born in 1911 in Rosine, Kentucky, a descendant of the president, James Monroe. Bill is considered the founder of bluegrass music.
What is it you want, Barry? You want the moon? Just say the word and I'll throw a lasso around it and pull it down. Hey, that's a pretty good idea. I'll give you the moon, Barry.
I'll take it.
Rufus Perriman recorded under the name Piano Red on the Groove record label. Mostly he recorded blues, but here's a song the Beatles picked up on and recorded. Piano Red, Mr. Moonlight.
Mr. Moonlight. You came to me.
Mr. Moonlight by Piano Red on Theme Time Radio Hour. Soon as the evening shades prevail, the moon takes up the wondrous tale. Moonlight in Vermont, a romantic song about evening summer breeze and the warbling of a meadowlark, sycamore trees. Snowlight on a trail, moonlight in Vermont. This is Ella and Louie, along with Oscar Peterson and Buddy Rich, for their 1956 recording, Moonlight in Vermont.
Pennies in a stream, falling leaves, a sycamore, moonlight in Vermont. Cables birds they sing down the highway and travel each bend in the road. People who meet in this romantic setting are so hypnotized by the lovely evening summer breeze, wobbling of a meadowlark, moonlight in Vermont.
Setting so hypnotized by the lovely
evening summer breeze, wobbling of a meadowlark, moonlight in Vermont.
Fitzgerald, Louis Armstrong, Moonlight in Vermont. Vermont, maple syrup, greatest number of dairy cows in the country. Here's a song like the old Buddha saying, there are three things that cannot be hidden, the sun, the moon, and the truth. It's a Barnum and Bailey world, just as phony as it can be. Big D Irwin's gonna tell us all about it. It's only a paper moon.
Say it's only a paper moon. Without
is Only a Paper Moon, a folk rock version by Big D. Irwin, a New York-based singer. Recorded a number of songs with Little Eva, who did the Locomotion. It's Only a Paper Moon has been written by Harold Arlen, who also wrote all the Wizard of Oz stuff. Songs, I mean. The movie Paper Moon won an Academy Award for Tatum O'Neill.
The first footsteps on this strange new world must be taken cautiously. The moon has only 1/6 the gravity of Earth. The nature of its surface was still unknown.
Coming up next on Theme Time Radio Hour, Red LeBlanc and his Crescent Boys. Yes, indeed, there is a blue moon on the bayou. Red LeBlanc.
There's a blue moon on the bayou tonight. Shine so bright, but the sweetest girl that I've ever known left me with my blue moon tonight. Blue moon, change your color, send her back to me, shine down on her wherever she may be.
Red LeBlanc and his Crescent Boys on Eddie Shuler's Gold Band Records. Blue Moon on the Bayou. A bayou is a body of water, such as a creek or a small river, that is a tributary to a larger body of water, like they have down in Louisiana. A blue moon is the second full moon in a calendar month. It doesn't happen that often, and that's why they say, once in a blue moon. Here are the Neville Brothers, produced by Daniel Lanois, and their song, Yellow Moon.
Oh, yellow moon, yellow moon, why you keep peeping in my window? Do you know something? Do you know something that I don't know? Did you see my baby walking down them railroad tracks? Ooh, you couldn't tell me. We'll be right back.
Yellow Moon by the Neville Brothers. A little bit of voodoo from down in New Orleans.
The werewolf is neither man nor wolf, but a satanic creature with the worst qualities of both.
And do you expect me to believe that a man so afflicted actually becomes a wolf under the influence of the full moon? I'm afraid, sir, that I gave up my belief in goblins, witches, personal devils, and werewolves at the age of 6.
Next up, Cliffy Stone, born in Burbank in 1917. He became the bass player on the Lucky Stars radio show. Also played on a radio show called Hometown Jamboree. It was a who's who of the music world, including Tennessee Ernie Ford, Merle Travis, Molly B, Speedy West, Jimmy Bryant, and his father, Herman the Hermit. He brought country music to Hollywood and wrote songs such as this one: When My Blue Moon Turns to Gold Again, When the Rainbow Turns the Clouds Away. Cliffy Stone.
When my blue moon turns to gold again, when the rainbow turns the clouds away, when my blue moon turns to gold again, memories that linger in my heart, memories that make my heart grow cold, but someday they'll live again, sweetheart, and my blue moon again will turn to gold. When my blue to gold again, when the rainbow turns the clouds away, when my blue moon turns to gold again, you'll be back within my arms to stay. My golden moon is just a memory. When my blue moon turns to gold again, when the rainbow turns the clouds away, when my blue moon turns to gold again, you'll be back with stay.
Cliffy Stone, When My Blue Moon Turns to Gold Again. In the 1940s, he signed to Capitol Records as the head of the country and western department. and helped build their great country roster, including Merle Haggard and Buck Owens. He wrote two books, Everything You've Always Wanted to Know About Songwriting But Didn't Know Who to Ask, and You Gotta Be Bad Before You Can Be Good.
You want the world of tomorrow, Alice? You want the world of tomorrow? I'll give you the world of tomorrow. You're going to the moon!
Come and take a trip in my rocket ship. We'll have a supersonic rendezvous, breaking out of the clouds at midnight, present like an archangel at the creation of light and of the world. The rising moon that looks for us again. Straight to the moon. I'll be out of this world with you. The earth will be like a toy balloon. Destination moon. The great Dinah Washington.
We'll have a lovely afternoon. Kiss the world goodbye, and away we'll fly. Destination moon. We'll travel fast as a light till we're out of sight. The earth will be like a toy balloon. What a thrill you'll get riding on my jet. A destination moon. We'll go up, 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 up. Straight to the moon we two, high in the starry blue. I'll be out of this world with you. So away we'll steal in my space mobile, a supersonic, a honeymoon. Leave your cares below, pull the switch, let's go. A destination moon. We'll be high in the starry blue. I'll be out of this world with you. So away we'll steal in my jet mobile, a supersonic honeymoon. Leave your cares below, pull that switch, let's go. Destination. We're flying high up in the sky. Destination moon.
It's a quarter of a million miles from the earth to the moon, and there's no one I'd rather go with than Dinah Washington. Coming up next, there's a moon out tonight by the Capris, a vocal group out of Queens, New York. This reached number 3 on the Billboard charts in 1961. This song is talking about a glow in my heart. Because there's a girl at my side, and I want to go strolling through the park, the Capris.
There's a moon out tonight. Let's go strolling. There's a girl in my heart. Whose heart I've stolen. There's a moon out tonight. Let's go strolling through. Oh,
there's a moon out tonight. The Capris. A lot of the early doo-wop groups were named after birds. The Orioles, the Cardinals, the Blue Jays, the Robins, the Sparrows, the Bald Eagles, the Penguins, which is a flightless bird. A bird you would not want to fly you to the moon. Here's a kind of an unorthodox version of Fly Me to the Moon. Bobby Womack on Theme Time Radio Hour. Bobby Womack, he want to sing for you now forever. Fly Me to the Moon. Bobby is a great guitarist and a great songwriter. He wrote songs like Looking for a Love, It's All Over Now, I'm a Midnight Mover, and Harry Hippie. Bobby was a close friend of Sam Cooke, and after Sam's tragic death, Bobby married Cooke's widow just 3 months later.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
George Bernard Shaw once said, I don't know if there's men on the moon, but if there are, they must be using the Earth as their lunatic asylum. Which brings me to one of my favorite crazy people. Bully Slim Gallard was born in Detroit, Michigan, 1916. He invented his own crazy jive language called Vout. Jack Kerouac wrote about Slim Gallard in his book On the Road. One night we suddenly went mad together again. We went to see Slim Gaylord in a little Frisco nightclub. Slim Gaylord is a tall, thin Negro with big, sad eyes who's always saying, Right a Rooney. And how about a little bourbon a Rooney? In Frisco, great, eager crowds of young semi-intellectuals stood at his feet and listened to him on the piano, guitar, and bongo drums. When he gets warmed up, he really takes off his undershirt and really goes. He goes, he does, and says anything that comes into his head. He'll sing Cement Mixer, Putty Putty, and suddenly slow down the beat and brood over his bongos with fingertips barely tapping the skin as everyone leans forward breathlessly to hear. You think he'll do this for a minute or so, but he goes right on for as long as an hour, making an imperceptible little noise with the tips of his fingernails smaller and smaller all the time till you can't hear it anymore and sounds and traffic come in and open door. Then he slowly gets up and takes the mic and says very slowly, Great O'Rooney, fine O'Wooty, hello O'Rooney, bourbon O'Rooney, all O'Rooney, how are the boys in the front row making out with their girls O'Rooney? O'Rooney, Voti, O'Rooney, Voti. O'Rooney, O'Rooney, he keeps this up for 15 minutes, his voice getting softer and softer, and you can't hear. His great sad eyes scan the audience. Dean stands up in the back and says, God, yes, and clasping his hands in prayer and sweating. Sal, Slim knows time. He knows time. Slim sits down at the piano and hits two notes, two C's, then two more, then one, then two. And then suddenly the big burly bass player wakes up from a reverie and realizes Slim is playing C-Jam blues. And he slugs in his big forefinger on the string. And the big booming beat begins and everybody starts rocking. And Slim looks just as sad as ever. And they blow jazz for half an hour. And then Slim goes mad and grabs the bongos and plays tremendous rapid Cubana beats and yells crazy things in Spanish, in Arabic, in Peruvian dialect, in Egyptian, in every language he knows. And he knows innumerable languages. Finally, the set is over. Each set takes 2 hours. Slim Gaylord goes and stands against a post, looking sadly over everybody's head as people come talk to him. A bourbon is slipped into his hand. Bourbon or Rooney, thank you, Ovudi. No one knows who Slim Gaylord is. Dean once had a dream that he was having a baby, and his belly was all bloated up as blue as he lay on the grass of a California hospital under a tree with a group of colored men sat Slim Gaylord. Dean turned despairing eyes of a mother to him. Slim said, "There you go, O'Rooney." Oh, Dean approached him. He approached his God. He thought Slim was God. He shuffled and bowed in front of him and asked him to join us. "Right, O'Rooney," says Slim. "He'll join anybody but won't guarantee to be there with you in spirit." Dean got a table, bought drinks, and sat stiffly in front of Slim. Slim dreamed over his head. Every time Slim said, "O'Rooney," Dean said, "Yes." I stood there with these two madmen. Nothing happened. To Slim Gaylord, the whole world was just one big old Rooney. Here's Slim with "How High the Moon."
Somewhere there's music, moon, stars, oh, the planets flying through the skies. Right before your eyes, you can see everything that's happening through the skies. Music, somewhere, how high the moon. Everybody's wondering, hey, everybody's wondering how high the moon. The moon never wonder how low you are, how far. Around through the skies, zoom, 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 they will be orbiting you. Let's orbit the moon, and we moon, 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 I'll orbit, dome it round and round through the stars, skies, sail, zoom, here they come, there they go, they are flying, speeding at 982,000 million miles an hour. Man, they're really flying. Orbit, orbit the moon, the sun, the stars. stars, Pluto, Jupiter, Mars, all the planets. What they gonna do when the planets all meet together and say, hello there, how are you? Bingo, explosion, that's really gonna really have a whaling time. When they have those Sunday afternoon jam sessions, they have 582,322,000,000,000 saxophones all wailing at one time. Oh, that'd be real crazy, really, really wealthy. Say, do you know what they have on the moon? Listen now, they raise potatoes, tomatoes, potatoes, and tomatoes, potatoes. Potatoes is the size of the Hollywood Bowl. How do they peel them? They peel them with a bulldozer. Oh, just imagine a nice big bowl of potato salad.
He wrote songs like Flatfoot Floogie and Cement Mixer Putty Putty. Flatfoot Floogie was so popular that it was buried in the 1939 World's Fair time capsule, along with Stars and Stripes Forever and Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue. The time capsule is set to be opened in the year 6939. I wonder what they'll make of Slim Gaylord then. And now it's time to say goodbye as the moon is slowly sinking and the sun is coming up from behind the Abernathy building. Remember to shoot for the moon, because if you miss, you will still be among the stars. See you next week here on Theme Time Radio Hour.
Been listening to Theme Time Radio Hour with your host Bob Dylan, produced by Eddie Gorodetsky, associate producer Sonny Webster, continuity by Eats Martin, edited by Damian Rodriguez, supervising editor Rob McCumber, the Theme Time research team Diane Lapson and Bernie Bernstein, with additional research by Lynn Sheridan, Kimberly Williams, and Robert Bauer, production assistance by Jim McBeam. Special thanks to Randy Azradi, Debbie Sweeney, Coco Shinomiya, and Samson Steiner. For XM Radio, Lee Abrams. Recorded in Studio B, the Abernathy Building. Studio engineer, Tex Carbone. This has been a Greywater Park production in association with Big Red Tree. This is your announcer, Pierre Mancini, speaking. Join us again next week for Theme Time Radio Hour when the subject is Countdown.